explain to all, this day, I'm going to present to you one of the apparatus of this physics laboratory, the triple beam balance. We all know, triple beam balance is used to measure object. It is also used in weighing of an object too. But before that, I'm going to demonstrate to you, or to present to you, the different parts of this triple beam balance. This is what we call the metal platform. And this one here is called the adjust knob or the adjust screw. This three here is called the riders. And this metal, three metals here, is called the beams. This part also here is called the pointer. And this one here is called the scale. So, that is all about the different parts of a triple beam balance. Next, I'm going to present to you using the balance. First, zero the balance before you determine the mass of any substance. The first step here is to slide all these riders back to 0 point. Then the next step is check to see the pointer swings freely along the scale. Then the next here is use this adjustment screw to obtain an equal swing of the beams if necessary. You do not have to wait for the pointer to stop at the 0 point. The beam should swing an equal distance above and below the 0 point. And one thing we are going to remember is you must repeat this 0 procedure to balance every time you use it. Using the balance, here is now the result of the 0 point. After 0 minute, it is now the time to get the mass of these objects. The first one, so we're going to measure this little one. You put it here. Then, we're going to move this rider, which is valuing by 100. So let's try 100. Then, as you can see, the pointer doesn't move. So let's move this rider again. Let's try 50. As you can see, it doesn't fit the scale. Try 40. And we use also this slider to make it balance. Let's try 80. It is heavier enough that it doesn't fit the scale. So let's try this move here by 5. As you can see, it is fit already. So the measure of this object is 147.5. Again, the measure of this object that we are weighing is 147.5. After measuring this little one, let's try this big one. So again, we put it here in the flat metal platform. Then, we use again these three riders here. The first one that we're going to move is this 100 rider. Let's try 300. As you can see, it doesn't fit to the scale. So, after weighing this little one, let's try this big one. So again, we put it here in the metal platform. Then, again, when measuring, we use this tree right out here. The first one that we're going to move is the hundredths rider. So let's try 300. As you can see, pointer is already down, so it means it is heavier enough. So let's move it here for adjust. Let's try 200. As you can see, still has to move. So, we use again this, another lighter. Let's try 100. Again, it doesn't fit the scale. We move for adjust this right there. Let's try 90. As you can see, it doesn't move again. So we use this one's right there. Let's try 10. So it is heavier enough, so we adjust this. Let's try 8. As you can see, pointer doesn't move. So let's try and adjust this right here. 4. It doesn't really fit to the scale. So we move this again. 5. As you can see, the pointer here is on the scale. So it means that the weight of this object is 295. Again, the measure of this big one for this object is 295. So that is all about measuring our weight of an object. So that's all I want to say. Thank you. Bye-bye.